Okay. So, in this session, we are going to be discussing about the concepts of simple graph, planar graph, and a regular graph, and a bridge, articulation point, and incidence. Okay. So, in the previous concepts, what we have discussed, we discussed about that, what do you mean by graph, and what is the difference between graph as well as a tree, and followed by what are the various types of graphs we are having, that is we have discussed. Okay, so continuation of the previous concept, the other types of graphs is, the first one is the simple graph. Okay, the simple graph, the definition of a simple graph is, a graph is said to be simple if and only if, without having self loop and without parallel edges, is called simple graph. Okay, so example for simple graph, let me give you a simple example for this. Okay, for this example, let me tell you, a graph without self loop and parallel edges, okay, that is called simple graph. For example, A, B, C, D, E. So here there is no vertex which is having, so this is a graph G. This is a graph G. So in this case, if you observe, there is no self transition for any particular vertex, and as well as there is no parallel edges are given. Okay, so this is called a simple graph. Okay, so in this case, what are the vertices we are having? The vertices are A comma, B comma, C comma, D comma, E. These are the vertices. Okay, here the edges are, how many edges we are having? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 edges we are having. As of our previous discussion, already I said that edge is nothing but, it is a connection in between two vertices of a graph, that is edge. Okay, so here edges you can able to represent, the edges are, okay, E of G equal to, how can I represent 4 edges I am having? That is, I can represent A comma B, and B comma D, and A comma C, and C comma E. These are the edges of a graph. Okay, so this is an example for simple graph. Okay, so without having self loop and without having parallel edges, then the graph is called simple graph. Okay, so the next concept is planar graph. Okay, what do you mean by planar graph? Is, so let me give a simple example for the planar graph. A graph is said to be planar graph without having edge intersection. Okay, or you can say that there is no edge must have interconnection or intersection. Okay, so one example let me give in this case. Okay, for this particular planar graph. Okay, planar graph as given as, a graph is said to be planar if and only if, a graph without having edge intersection. Okay, so let me give V1, V2, V3, V4. Okay, here how many vertices I am having? 4 vertices I am having. Okay, I can able to draw this one. Okay, so here there is no edges are intersected. Okay, if it is having intersection, that is nothing but non-planar graph. Okay, so this is an example for planar graph. Okay, what type of graph it is? It is a planar graph. Okay, what about non-planar graph? For example, for the same example, if I am taking the like this, V1, V2, 4 vertices I am taking, but here I am trying to give edge intersection. Okay, okay, so now here intersection is happened. Okay, so that's why it is called non-planar graph. This is an example for non-planar graph. Okay, this is non-planar graph G dash. Okay, so this is the difference between planar graph as well as non-planar graph. Okay, so how can we define? Planar graph is nothing but where edge should not have any intersection. Okay, here edge intersection if it is having, that is called non-planar graph. Okay, coming to the regular graph. Okay, Next one is coming to the regular graph. So the regular graph is defined as follows. In this case, every vertex must have same number of adjacent vertices. Okay, that is called regular graph. Okay, regular graph is defined as every vertex must have same number of adjacent vertices in a graph. Okay, that is nothing but regular graph. Okay, now let us take the example for regular graph. Okay, so example for regular graph, now you can take the same example. Okay, what it is, for example, vertex, let me tell you, and number of adjacent vertices. Number of adjacent vertices. Okay, so this is regular graph. This is regular graph. In this case, what you are observing, how many number of vertices you are having? 4 number of vertices we are having. If I am taking each and every vertex, and every vertex is having equal number of adjacent vertices in a graph. Okay, so let me take, for example, if I am taking V1, okay, how many adjacent vertices it is having? Is nothing but the connectivity in between the vertices. Okay, for the V1, V2 is one vertex and V3 is another vertex. So the number of adjacent vertices for V1 is 2. And coming to the V2, how many adjacent vertices? It is connected to V4 and V1. Okay, is nothing but the number of adjacent vertices for V2 is 2. Okay, and coming to the V3. Okay, here also, how many number of adjacent vertices you can able to give it? So it is connected V3 to V4, 1, and V3 to V1, another 2. So here also 2. And like the same way, you can also find out number of vertices of V4. Okay, V4 also connected with V2 as well as V3. So how many you are having? 2. Okay, so whenever you are considering the number of vertices of each and every vertex of a graph, if it is having the same count, okay, the count is the same. Now it is called regular graph. It is called regular graph. Okay, so this is a general definition of simple graph, planar graph and regular graph. Okay, all of you clear? Okay, right? So you have to remember what is simple graph, what is planar graph, what is regular graph. Okay, what is the next terminology is bridge. Okay, what do you mean by bridge? Generally, you may have an aware about the bridge. It is nothing but two different areas will be get connected through the bridge. Okay, the same terminology is required to apply here. Whenever two different graphs are there, two different graphs will be connected through a particular edge. The edge is called bridge here. Okay, in this case, if you remove the edge, the graph will be get disconnected and two separate graphs will be given. Okay, so let us take one example to define this particular bridge. Okay, so in this case, let us take one more example for the bridge. Okay, so let me take the same example for this. Okay, in this case, what I am taking? Some another V6, V7. Okay, in this case, if you take that consideration of this particular part, okay, this particular part, I can able to consider as a bridge. Okay, this is a graph G. Okay, this is, I can able to say that is an a bridge. Here I can able to say that this is an a bridge, because V4 comma V5, it is an edge actually. Okay, it acts as bridge here. Okay, because how can we define this particular one? Whenever if you are removing this particular V4 V5 edge, okay, then automatically the graph will be get disconnected, then two separate graphs will be created. Okay, so that's why I can able to say it is an a bridge. Okay, are you getting me? For example, this is a graph given. Okay. For example, if I am removing this particular bridge, what happened? For example, if I have removed. Okay. So in this case, what happened? You have created two different graphs. Okay. So that's why you can say it is an a bridge. Okay. The bridge will be specified as whenever if any particular edge is removed. Okay. If the graph is separated or disconnected and created two different graphs is called, that is a bridge. In this case, whatever I have highlighted, this is a bridge. Okay. If I am removing this, what happened? Two different graphs are created. Are you getting me? Okay. So that's why the bridge is defined as, it will be act as a connection between two different graphs. If I remove an edge from the graph, it will be get disconnected and creates two different graphs. It's called bridge. Okay. So this is the example for bridge. Okay. Coming to the articulation point. Okay. Here the articulation point is defined as in a graph. Okay. In a given graph G, if I am removing a vertex, again graph will be separated or disconnected and created two different graphs. Is called articulation points. Let me tell you that particular example in this case. Okay. So, however we have defined them for the bridge, the same way. Bridge is associated with for the edge. Okay. But articulation point is associated with the vertex. Okay. In the bridge, if I am removing the edge, graph is disconnected. In the case of articulation point, if I am removing the vertex, if the graph is disconnected, that particular vertex is called articulation point. Okay. So in this case, let me take a simple example. Here V4, V5, V6, V7, V8. Okay. So here in this case, which is articulation point? This is an articulation point, because in a graph G, if I am removing the V5, then two different graphs will be get created. Okay, so this is called articulation point, because if I am removing this particular one, what happened? Automatically two different graphs are created. Okay, so that's why in this case, V5 is called articulation point. Okay, so this is one more important point you have to remember. Okay, and next one is incidence. Okay, incidence is nothing but simply you are giving a label for the edge. Okay, that is nothing but incidence. Okay, E1, E2, E3, E4. Okay, here incidence of graph G, okay, where how many edges you are having? E1 is represented as V1 comma V2, okay, and like that is nothing but E1 is incident on V1 comma V2, and E2 is incident on V1 comma V3, and E3 is incident on V3 comma V4. That is nothing but incident. Sometimes you can able to say that giving some weightage or giving some labels for a given graph edges is called incident. Okay. So these are the following terminologies we have to remember as a part of our graph types as well as introduction parts. Okay. So this is regarding your simple graph, planar graph, regular graph and a bridge, articulation point and incidence. Okay. So here you have to remember these particular points. Okay.